Beautiful. Can you show me eyes up here? Beautiful. Thank you. We are ready to have fun, but we do want to be respectful of the people on the stage. So when there's people up here, I want to see eyes up here and listening ears, okay? And then up in the stand, as you guys can tell, I'm sure that those bleachers are a little rickety. So the least amount of movement you can make would be awesome because they do make a lot of noise for the people up here. I think we're ready. Are you guys ready to see the show? All right, but we do have one quick announcement. I'm going to invite my friend Mrs. Weaver out, and she's got some friends that are going to come out. You guys know these people, don't you? There you go.
And I'm here today because there are three people on the stage with us that we like to show a lot of respect to, aren't there? This week is National Custodial Week, and we want to show our custodians how much we appreciate everything they do for us. So I would like to introduce Mr. Jim, Ms. Jenny, and Ms. Nicole. And can we please give a big ZebraZone thank you to all of them?
Show respect to everybody, whether they're young or old, whether they're mean or nice, whether we work for them or they work for us. We want to show respect. And hey, parents, we've got a great idea this month. We're going to be handing out to you at the end of the show something really cool that you can use to teach your kids respect.
Is it a trip to Disney?
No, it's not a trip to Disney, but it is a first-class ticket.
To Disney?
Not exactly. You see, we want to give them a first-class way to show respect. Whether they're showing respect to maybe a clerk at the grocery store, whether it's a sibling, that one's kind of hard, whether it's parents or teachers, whoever they're showing respect to, parents, we're going to give you the opportunity to use these respect first-class tickets to hand those to your kids and work out a system where they can maybe trade those in for a reward at the end of the week.
Yeah, like a trip to Disney. I don't want a ticket to anything unless it gets me into Disney.
Well, that's good, because I don't foresee you getting a ticket anytime soon. You know what, though? I think there's somebody here who does deserve a ticket. Let's give Will a hand.
Good job, Will.
Good job, Will.
Get a ticket. My coffee is barely 2 degrees above lukewarm.
And you're about 2 seconds from trouble. All right, everybody. We're going to check out what's going on in the clubhouse.
What's a person got to do to get some respect in this town?
Hey, Columbia, you ready to get this party started?
Yeah!
Come on, you ready? Let's go! Put your hands together.
I'm going to walk.
I'm gonna walk.
18. We're not allowed to see anybody, or we might give them the flu.
Well, yeah, Gloria will have to shut us up like two old convicts in the big old house.
Well, you know, if we just drink plenty of water and just lay low, it'll just be a 24-hour bug.
Bug? I've met Brazilian flying cockroaches I like better than this. I gotta get up and about tonight. I'm officiating at the Caribou banquet.
Well, if you just relax, our bodies are made to heal themselves, Grandpa Henry. If you just relax and drink lots of fluids and eat what you're supposed to eat.
Don't go preaching that wheatgrass and inch of stuff at me.
Oh, come on, it'll be fun. It'll be like a slumber party.
You know, it's a small world that we both catch the same affliction.
Small world? That reminds me of my favorite song.
How about you just get amnesia real quick?
It's a small world after all. It's a small world after all.
Boy, you're making my ears bleed. You're making them bleed.
Well, you like this one better? I believe I can fly.
This getting better up process.
Are you sure you should do that?
Yeah. You know what? I'm gonna sweat. I'm gonna sweat right out of my body. Yep, nothing that a good aerobics can't fight the flu.
You shake my nerves and you rattle my brain.
I'm fine. Don't be going coddling the grand master of the Caribou Lodge.
Well, since sweating it out didn't work, you might want to just try relaxing.
No.
Lay back, close your eyes.
Sweating's gonna work it.
But exercise doesn't seem to agree with you, Grandpa Henry.
That's why I'm going to the holy grail of all cures.
Windex?
Nope. My great-granddaddy's cayenne jalapeno Louisiana hot sauce slather. I'm gonna mix some up here right now. See, I need some ground jalapeno peppers, grilled chili peppers. Let's get some mustard flavor. Oh, there's the Louisiana hot sauce.
Oh, really? Don't you just want some water?
What I want is a good old beat down on this awful play. Let's see what else. Oh, yeah. The ghost pepper.
The ghost pepper? Isn't that 401.5 times hotter than Tabasco sauce?
Here I come. Caribou banquet. Now that's what I call.
Oh, you sweat now, Henry!
Oh, who fire? Who fire?
Oh. Yeah, Henry, don't worry. Don't worry. I'll help. I'll help you, Grandpa Henry. I'll help.
You sing. important by what you say and do.
What you want, baby, I got it. What you need, no, I got it. All I'm asking is for a little respect. Just love it, just love it, just love it, just love it. R-E-S-P-E-C-T, find out what it means to me. R-E-S-P-E-C-T, love me out, show what you mean.
Going into every time teachers and staff see kids that are showing respect. Have you heard me on the morning announcements reading off tons of names? Remy, there are so many kids out here showing respect. Can you believe it? They're amazing. So what we're going to do right now is draw one name of one student who is going to win a bicycle. Oh, and a bicycle just for showing respect? Okay, so here's what we need to do. Check out all those. I think it's the most we've ever had. There are a ton of names in here. So I'm going to draw. Oh, I know this girl. She's a first grader. And she shows respect by always thinking of what she should say and do. Is that respectful? This is a little girl in Mrs. Lunsford's class, and it is Katya Andronova. Come on down, Miss Katya. Did you really win a bicycle for showing respect? I'm so excited for you. Come on over. You want to say hi to Zebby? Way to go. Katya, take a look. We have a problem because there's no bike up here. What do you think we should do about that? Maybe we've been thinking about this. Last year, we found that sometimes we got a big bike for a smaller person, and sometimes we got a little bike for a taller person. So we decided we're gonna just let you pick out the bike that you think would be a good fit. How's that sound? Do you know how to ride a bicycle? Yeah? You think that's going to be pretty fun? Okay, good. I'm so proud of you, Katya. On what?
On two wheels.
First grader on two wheels? Are you kidding me? You're awesome. I'm very proud of you. All right, let's give her one more big hand. Way to go. Okay. Isn't that great? I love it. Now, I want you guys to all give yourselves one more big round of applause for showing respect this month. Way to go, guys. Oh, round of applause. Show them again, Zebby. Round of applause. Oh, yeah. Zebby, Zebby, Zebby. Enjoy the rest of the show. Come on, you crazy thing.
I'm full of antibodies.
Hey, Dad, y'all ready to go to the doctor?
24-hour bug. Been down this dag-burned road for 3 days. I'm still sicker than a turtle with a cracked shell. Missed my caribou dinner and everything.
Well, you know, it might have helped if you showed the doctor a little respect and actually listened to the directions he gave you, like Marshall here did.
Well, let me just say, you know, maybe you've got a point, Gloria.
Yeah, Grandpa Henry, that wasn't very respectful of you to just ignore what the doctor said. He knows about your body, how to make it feel better, you know. You gotta respect that.
Well, it must have just pains me, Marshall. You pounded that nail on the head.
And don't you worry.
All right, come on, Dad. Let's go get you out to the car.
And don't worry, I'll come with you and cheer you up. Let's go to a nice, peaceful, beautiful place. Oh, I know. Yeah, it's a small world.
Hey, turn it, boy! The dad don't need to have your surroundings, too. Gloria, no, I would highly advise against that action, course of action. Even though it did help shove me down the road to that right direction of respecting Dr. Philbin, because he knows how to make me healthy when I'm sick.
Yeah, I learned that same thing. What a small world. It's a small world after all.
These are going to be at the ticket. And it doesn't have to be, you don't have to spend money on a reward. It could just be that you get to play a game together or you get to go to the park, something like that that your child would enjoy. So we want to make sure that we reward our zebras for being very respectful. Thanks so much.
All right, Columbia. It's time to say goodbye. Have you had fun?
We're gonna make it.